Hey, what's up, everybody? So it's Do Something Saturday. We're here. You got some of the food from Do Something Saturday, right?
That's right. It was delicious.
Cool. What's your name?
Jan.
Jan. And how long have you been homeless?
Essentially since July, but out here only about a month.
Okay. And how's it been?
Oh, it's had its ups and downs. Sometimes there's a deep sense of camaraderie. And other times you find there's a lot of scam artists out there, and it's really rough, especially for a woman.
Mm-hmm.
I guess maybe for a guy as well.
Right.
In that department. But there are sometimes resources that one can tap into, at least ostensibly. But then you go to tap into those, and they're not available. For instance, I tried to take a shower today at a place that was supposed to be opened, and it was not. And things like that. And also, I've been told that to get a caseworker, which you need to get certain resources, it takes like another month or so here.
Right.
It's a lot of red tape, in other words.
So would you say that it's been your experience that there's more red tape in you actually getting the services that you need to help you get back on track?
Thus far, I've said to one person who did an intake with me at a place called Daybreak, that I'm interested in actually not being a part of the problem, but actually participating, because I find that I can talk to a lot of the more mentally ill types and calm a lot of them down very well.
Mm-hmm.
She just kind of just
brushed you aside.
Yeah, that's the word. And it kind of hurt, Said, well, first things first. And I mean, to me, that was going without saying, or goes without saying. But, it hurt because it made me feel like I'm that I'm being condescended to.
Yeah. And you're not smart enough to actually help somebody.
Yes, exactly. And people don't seem to believe me when I say, I went to college for close to 6 years. They think I'm just crazy.
And even if you are just crazy, you can still contribute.
Sure.
Exactly.
Right. And proper meds or whatever.
Exactly.
Therapy.
Exactly.
Mm-hmm.
So, have you gotten more support from individuals than you would say from organizations like Daybreak, OPCC, St. Joseph's Center?
Definitely, I would say that's the case.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Now, earlier we were talking about PETA and mm-hmm. their fur coat giveaway in Washington, D.C.
Mm-hmm.
Tell me, I'm on a blog called change.org, and the blog is talking about PETA giving away these fur coats, and there's a lot of people that have a problem with PETA giving homeless people fur coats because they think homeless people are being exploited. And my thinking is, from being formerly homeless, is that if a homeless person has very strong convictions about animal rights, they're not going to accept that fur coat.
Correct.
But if they're cold, they're going to accept that fur coat.
Sure. And,
what are your thoughts on that?
Well, being homeless makes you do things that you wouldn't normally do anyway, neglecting your hygiene or whatever it could be. I mean, there's so many things that you have to think about just at the basic pyramid of importance. You got to think about your food and shelter
mm-hmm.
needs, and who cares if it's a fur coat or not a fur coat? You just want to be warm, depending on where you're at, And in fact, I used to live in Philadelphia, and as I was going into my college classes and other people were going into their jobs, we'd be stepping over the homeless lying there on the grates, on the steam grates, and one of those fur coats would have been just wonderful for them.
Yeah, because when you get up off that grate, you're cold.
Oh, yeah.
Trust me, I've done it in downtown L.A.
Yeah, and it gets darn cold here, too.
It does, and a lot of people think in Southern California it doesn't get cold. It mm-hmm. does. Once you've been here for a while and you adjust,
uh-huh.
it's cold here. And
yeah.
I grew up here. It gets cold here at night.
Yeah, and you have to think about the fact that you're sleeping on concrete in many cases, because I don't believe we're allowed to do it on the beach.
You're not. not.
You know, you can sneak, but and that's but then you get the wind from the wave. So you kind of can't win, you know, and then they keep chasing you off from various locations. Let's say if you find an area where the wind doesn't whip around, you know, you're kind of protected, then they, if they see you there, they make you move. So a fur coat would work.
A fur coat would definitely
work. Yeah, who cares? I'm against killing animals for fur, but I'd take a fur coat. And, you know, and I mean, if these people are gonna, your well-off or beautiful people are going to wear them just to look good, then they might as well, you know, go ahead and give the ones that aren't being used to the homeless, or you know, because otherwise, I guess, what are they gonna do? Burn them?
Yeah, and that's worse than what happened to the animal. Why burn it when you can actually keep somebody warm with it?
I mean, isn't that what our Native Americans did? You know, they took the buffalo hide and, you know, and used it.
Drop knowledge on them, baby. Drop knowledge.
So there you are.
So would you be interested in talking about your experiences on like maybe a weekly or biweekly basis?
Sure.
And if there were a couple of items you could ask for right now, what would it be? Because I've heard everybody say, and I know from my experience, socks were like gold out
here. Well, socks definitely. I've had to throw away many, many, many pair. Okay, well, kind of a couple of personal items. I hope this isn't embarrassing. I actually need panties and a new bra because I'm losing weight out here.
She needs panties and a new bra, America.
I'm losing my babies.
What was your name again?
Jan.
This was Jan, guys. This is Do Something Saturday. This is one of the people that I support. So if you would like to send, what sizes are you?
I think now it's down to 36C.
Okay.
And the underwear, I guess, like large. I don't know.
So if you guys want to support Jan through my organization, go to www.dosomethingsaturday.org. Shoot me an email and let me know that you would like to contribute what Jan requests. Thanks, Jan.
Okay, you're welcome.
Bye-bye.
Bye.